I have seen many merchants in my life, but don't you think there aren't many like him who are in no hurry to do business?
Therefore, Luo Cha is just the name I use within the Xianzhou. Outside of the Xianzhou, I use something more difficult to pronounce. I'm guessing you want to know that name too? The universe is a dangerous place. The IPC and the Alliance only provide for our safety during interstellar travel. On-site security is dependent on our own capacities. As such, I had to improve my swordplay and healing skills. You are also a wanderer, young master Don Hung. Surely you understand. Ah, a story of ill luck. I found myself embroiled in a conflict and ended up owing a favor. Now I must assist in delivering these remains back to the Xianzhou. It would seem I am a magnet for such misfortune. I thought I would be safe on the Law Fu. But now...
In a universe filled with mysterious characters, Luo Cha stands out to me for a number of reasons. So let's take a look into what we know about him, his connections to other characters, and his potential role in the story. Luo Cha is a healer following the Path of Abundance, who claims to work for the Intergalactic Merchant Guild and carries a coffin containing an unknown individual. We first meet him on the Xianzhou Lao Fu with Sushong, where he tells us his reason for being there is to return the body within the coffin. After Sushong questions him, he explains that the person inside isn't a friend, and that he's only delivering them due to owing someone a favor. This seems to be confirmed from his light cone text. Under the watch of the white irises, he bashed the coffin with his hands. Sometimes I feel like I underestimated you by proposing this deal. It seems to me like he's talking to the person inside the coffin here, and that they have some sort of consciousness left to hear him. So, who is in the coffin? Since Luo Cha is a follower of Abundance, and the Lao Fu is experiencing problems with Mara, a disease that turns immortals into monsters, associated with the Aeon of Abundance, Yaosha, I wonder if the person inside is Mara-struck and made a deal with Luo Cha in order to be smuggled onto the Lao Fu. My first thoughts go to Jing Yuan's master, Jing Liu, who may have survived his final attack and want to return home, though what her motives could be is still a mystery right now. I think the maiden Venera from the Knight of Purity Palace set is the most likely candidate. The people of her church seem to have been blessed by Yaosha in order to fight against who they call devils, but eventually most of the members went mad and the church was destroyed, with it sounding a lot like what happens to the Mara-struck. If Luo Cha was a member of the church, perhaps Venera's knight, Safina, or even Venera herself, made a deal with him to find a cure or revive Venera in exchange for immortality. Another who comes to mind is Yaosha, or an emanator of hers. In this case, the reason for returning to the Lao Fu may be to rejuvenate their damaged body with the fruits of the ambrosial arbor tree, explaining who caused the Stellaron explosion and why. Luo Cha, following the Path of Abundance, suggests that he may be part of a mysterious group known as the Elixir Seekers, who are rumored to be searching for Yaosha and a path to immortality. So perhaps the deal he made involved obtaining one of the fruits of immortality after the Ambrosial Arbor Tree was revived. I can't think of anyone else we know of, so perhaps it's someone we've never met before. Let me know if you have any ideas. As for Luo Cha possibly being an Elixir Seeker, there's more that points towards immortality being his goal in the parallels with him and Otto Apocalypse. If you've never played Honkai Impact 3rd, you might be wondering about who Otto Apocalypse was, so here's a very brief rundown of him and the similarities with Luo Cha so far. Otto was Honkai Impact 3rd's main villain and the leader of Shixal, basically a superpowered version of the church that controlled most of the world. Obsessed with reviving his friend, he performed many inhumane acts in order to bring her back. He traveled with her coffin to a place called Shenzhou to ask the immortal Fu Hua how to bring her back to life. Here, he met Fu Hua's disciple, Li Sushong, but discovered that they didn't know how to revive his friend. Pretty big similarities already, traveling with a coffin to a place called Shenzhou where immortals lived and meeting a girl called Sushong. The difference here is that Lord Cha doesn't seem to care for his coffinized friend and doesn't seem to want to revive them either. But if we replace reviving his friend with Lord Cha trying to become immortal by making a deal with the person inside the coffin, his motives become a bit clearer. If Lord Cha is an alternate universe version of Otto, it raises interesting questions about the connections between different versions of characters in the Star Rail universe, and the most interesting one for me is Void Archives. Void Archives is an AI created to contain a virtual library of information, as well as being able to recreate anything it understands. It and Welt were enemies in the Honkai Impact 3rd storyline, forced to work together, and Himiko confirms it arrived in the Star Rail universe with Welt, leaving the Astral Express before we arrived. So, if we consider Lord Cha as the Star Rail universe's version of Otto, it naturally leads us to wonder, could there also exist a parallel to Void Archives? And I think I found the answer. Void Archives seems to be created from a material called Solium, a liquid gold substance formed from nanorobots that could reshape itself, but needed a host to be used properly. After using herself as a host, its creator realized that due to its nature, it could become like a godlike threat to humanity. So she sealed it away for 50,000 years. Otto would later unseal it and became its host for 500 years, while it tried to take full control of his body. He managed to live so long by using its knowledge to create avatars of himself made from Solium, and eventually gave it control of one of them. So when I read about the golden liquid called Runation Filament that originates from Nanook, it made me wonder, could it be a similar substance to what Void Archives was created from, and if so, is Nanook the Void Archives of the Star Rail universe? And there's even more on this from a stage play in the game, describing a battle between someone resembling Lord Cha and Nanook. The Supreme Executioner finally recalled their homeworld, where it was ruled by an unjust power. They assembled a force of myriad Void Rangers to demand an answer from their past. Unfortunately, they were met with a surnameless fool guarding the portal. Wielding a rapier with extraordinary power, the fool dodged most skillfully, like a slippery fish in a pond, or a flash of a falling star. The Ruin Author did battle with the fool for 7 days and 7 nights, and eventually, golden ichor seeped out of their divine body. This is the origin of that unhealed wound. This story might be purely fictional, but given that Otto was often called a fool, and Lord Cha wields a rapier based on the powerful weapon known as the Abyss Flower, is it possible that he defeated the seemingly most powerful Aeon and forced him to retreat? And if so, how did he get that power? Even if he was an emanator of Yao She, that's still a level below an Aeon, and I'd imagine not enough to defeat Nanook. But the Abyss Flower, at least in Honkai Impact 3rd, was able to recreate and destroy matter at the atomic level. So, if Lord Cha's Abyss Flower is on that level of power, I can see how it could damage even Nanook and cause him to bleed the golden liquid. I still don't know how he could dodge attacks from an Aeon so easily, unless he has another trick up his sleeve, which is very likely. There is another possibility that could make sense though. Maybe Void Archives leaving the Astral Express was because it discovered Nanook was an alternate version of itself, and if they fought, I'd imagine it'd have an advantage over Nanook, with it being over 50,000 years old and learning all of Otto's deceptive ways over the past 500 years. Nanook is said to be one of the youngest Aeons too, and searching for answers in the story, kind of hinting at his overall inexperience. Perhaps in this version of events, Void Archives was also injured and made a deal with Lord Char as it did with Otto Apocalypse in the past. Hopefully we'll find out more about him in 1.2. So who do you think Lord Char is? Who is in the coffin? And what do you think would happen if Void Archives and Lord Char ever met? Let me know what you think in the comments below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, consider leaving a like and subscribe for more deep dives into your favorite characters. Let me know who you'd like me to cover next, and I'll see you in the next video.